Filipinos are still flocking to Bacawe in Bulacan, also known as the Philippines' fireworks capital, ahead of the New Year revelry. Let's get the latest now from Zian Ambrosio. She joins us live from Bacawe in Bulacan. Zian, what more can you tell us?
Casey, as of this time, fireworks buyers come and go here in Bacawe, Bulacan. Some came all the way from Manila, Pampanga, and other provinces, since according to them, the cheapest prices of fireworks are found here in Bacawe, Bulacan. As early as 7 this morning, buyers arrived at the fireworks stores here in Bacawe, Bulacan to buy their firecrackers and pyrotechnic devices. Some of the prices have doubled, but the buyers continue to order boxes of fireworks. The best seller items include the Roman candle or luces, which costs 80 pesos to 100 pesos for every 10 pieces. The regular fountain costs approximately 100 pesos to 300 pesos per piece. The jumbo fountain costs 400 to 800 pesos per piece. While the aerial fireworks with 16 shots is worth 2,800 pesos to 3,000 pesos per box. And there are also big aerial fireworks or the family pack with 200 shots that costs 40,000 pesos per box. The most expensive one with 300 aerial shots costs 50,000 pesos. According to the owners of fireworks stores, those who buy expensive pyrotechnics are usually the politicians and businessmen who celebrate their company New Year's party. The owners of the fireworks stalls also clarified that the prices vary depending on the brand, quality, design, and their supplier. The major manufacturers of fireworks are also located here in Bulacan, such as in San Rafael and Pulilan, Bulacan. Carmina, since the other day, we have noticed that the prices of fireworks have gone up today. It is expected to further increase before the New Year celebration. And that's the latest here in Bacawe, Bulacan. Casey?
Yes, Zia, and I think it was yesterday when we last talked, and we talked about, you mentioned that there are some components of some fireworks that have yet to make their way to the sellers. Have they been able to get those components, and or are they going to be able to sell those fireworks after they get assembled, or those fireworks are just going to have to wait for another time? Maybe, as you said, Chinese New Year.
Yes, Carmina, we talked to the head of the fireworks factory, fireworks stores here in Bacawe, Bulacan, and she said that it won't be able to reach here on time. So most likely they will be using it already for Chinese New Year, since the components, as we earlier said, it comes from Germany, China, and other countries. So they still have to wait for it, and they expect it to come after New Year. Carmina.
All right, thanks a lot. Zian Ambrosio there, joining us live from Bacawe in Bulacan. Thanks, Z. Well, back here at home, as we mentioned, a brewing storm threatens to bring more rains and floods to parts of Mindanao, the very same areas dealing with rising or with flash floods that have yet to really fully subside. We're going to get more details now from PAGASA weather forecaster Anna Cloran. Anna, what more can you tell us about this weather disturbance?
Yes, good afternoon, Ma'am Carmina and to our televiewers. This is the latest update to the low pressure area that we're now monitoring. It was last estimated at around 260 kilometers northeast of Hinatuan, Surigao del Sur. The possibility of this weather disturbance to develop into a tropical depression is not ruled out. Even if this low pressure area, even if this weather system or this low pressure area will or will not develop into a tropical cyclone, this will bring moderate to heavy with at times intense rains over the eastern Visayas. While moderate to at times heavy rains is still expected over the Caraga region, northern Mindanao, Davao region, Zamboanga Peninsula, the rest of Visayas, Bicol region, and Palawan. The northeast monsoon is still affecting the whole Luzon, bringing cloudy skies with light to moderate rains over the Cagayan Valley area, Cordillera Administrative Region, Aurora, Quezon, and Bicol region. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, we're expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated light rains. While the rest of Mindanao, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to the localized thunderstorms. We still have gale warning raised over the seaboards of northern and central Luzon, seaboards of southern Luzon, and the western seaboards of Visayas and the eastern seaboards of Visayas and Mindanao. Fishing boats and other small sea caravans are advised not to venture out into the sea while the larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Loren reporting for ANC.
Thanks a lot, Anna. And to you and the rest of the team, Happy New Year to you guys. We appreciate all that you do.